Directing the eye in 3D space has some unique challenges, but when we do it successfully, we reduce cognitive load, minimize disorientation, speed up visual processing, and increase comprehension. Luckily, there is a wealth of visual design knowledge that we can draw from. The key is to create clear visual hierarchies so your participant always knows where to look. One of the primary tools in your arsenal is contrast. It could be contrast in color, contrast in value, shape, scale, etc. But notice how your eye automatically goes to the specific locations within these compositions? That's not magic, that's contrast. Negative space is another way of creating visual contrast. When you surround something with nothing, you can't help but look at the something in the middle of it all. Movement is another powerful way to direct the eye in 3D space. I often attach an animation to a proximity trigger so that as the participant approaches the object, it begins to move and their eye is drawn to it. Most commonly, I use a combination of all of these techniques. Let's walk through a recent project of mine and I'll explain how I use these tools to direct the eye in 3D space. Warm colors tend to pull focus, so the orange gradient at the bottom uses both color and movement to draw your eye to the mountain, which is the perfect position to be in to see the next piece I want you to focus on, which is the quote sun. I then use the behavior builder to create a series of show actions with progressively longer delays to space out the appearance of all the new elements. To do this, I select the item I want to appear, then I open the behavior builder and I add a trigger. Next, I add a show action, I scroll down to the delay function, and then I assign it a time. I repeat this step with all of the elements that I want to appear using incrementally longer wait times so that things appear at a comfortable pace for the eye. As I mentioned before, warm colors pull the eye, so the main focal points of the piece all use a bright red. The central focal point, the head, uses a combination of contrasting bright colors to create a visually dynamic pattern. It's the only element with this high contrast pattern, so it really pulls the eye. But I've also added movement and placed it in the center of the experience, making sure to add some empty space around it. The secondary focal point is the red flowers. I've attached proximity triggers to them so that when a participant gets close to them, they start to spin, pulling your focus to their beautiful blossoms. Now you have a better sense of how I layer all of these techniques to create visual hierarchies. The resulting piece feels clear, vibrant, and alive. If you'd like to take a deeper dive into how I set up this project, I've included the source materials below.